Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri. Today is January 31st, 2023, and today OpenAI introduced a new tool called AI Classifier. As per OpenAI, this is a tool which is a classifier trained to distinguish between AI written and human written text. So in this video, I'm going to experiment with this tool and find out whether it can really detect the AI written code versus the handwritten code. So let's go and check it out. So they put the announcement on this post. I'll put the link in the description of this video. But once you open this page on your browser, you need to go and click on this try the classifier. It will open a new window. You need to log in. You can log in with your own Google account or the account that you have already created to access the ChatGPT. You can use the same account. So once you log in, this is a page which will come to your screen. So this is your playground. So you put the text here and click on submit, and this tool is supposed to tell you whether this code is written by a human or if this is an AI generated code, or third category is it's not able to identify whether the code is written by human or it's an AI generated tool. So as I told you before, let's experiment that. So to experiment, here I am inside ChatGPT, and I told ChatGPT to write a 500 word paragraph describing Canada tourism. So let's copy the entire response and put it in this text box and click on submit. And it's telling that it's very unlikely AI generated, which is not true because it's definitely an AI generated content. So the first experiment failed. Let's check the second one. So in this one, I have told ChatGPT to write 500 words describing artificial intelligence. So let's copy paste that. And again, let's clear that, put it here and submit. It's telling it's likely AI generated, which I agree. So what I have done is that I've already done two tests. One is about Canada tourism, where it failed. I have done the second experiment, which includes the artificial intelligence. It passed. So now here I have the same content, which is basically artificial intelligence, but this time it is actually an AI generated code, which is a ChatGPT written code. So let's copy that and paste it here. It's AI generated code, which is absolutely correct. So what I have done, I have put this entire text in a paraphrasing tool called Quillbot, and then Quillbot gave me this text. So let's copy that and put it in AI text classifier. And here it's telling it's unclear, if it's not sure whether it's written by a human or it's written by AI, which makes sense because it actually a mixture of AI and a paraphrasing tool. Though if you tell me, it should be a message that it's still an AI generated code. Now let's go to my blog. I know my posts are always written by me. So if I go to my blog and open, let's say any post, let's say this one, I know this portion of the code is definitely written by me. So why don't I copy that and put it here? And let's see if it is what it's telling. It's telling it's likely an AI generated code, which is not true. Wow. What about go to my another post, how to create a custom image? What is a custom image and all this thing? Let's put that in my AI text classifier again. Submit. It looks like this time it passed because it's telling that it's very unlikely it's an AI generated code. So it's a human written code. Let's check out this post, understanding Google Cloud pricing model and discount. So let's copy this portion of the code and put it here. It's unclear. Again, it should be a human written code. Introduction to Dart. Let's copy that, put it here and submit. Okay, so this is one limitation, that you need at least 1,000 characters so that this tool can predict. I've done a couple of tests, and what I understood, or what is my feeling, is that even though this tool is a very initial stage, that's what they're claiming, is that this is not a tool that you should be using for your primary decision-making tool, because it's still a work in progress. So they are already mentioning in the post that their classifier is not fully reliable. And with this classifier, it correctly identifies only 26% of the AI-written text as likely AI-written. So this is work in progress classifier. There are a couple of limitations. For one of the limitations is you need to have 1000 characters so the classifier can predict whether it's AI-written code or not. Sometimes human-written text will be incorrectly but confidently labeled as AI written by your classifier, which I've already seen in my experiments. Currently, the only language it supports is English. So I think it's a good start, but there is more scope to improve this classifier. So let me know what you think. Put your feedback in the comment section and we'll see in the next video. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.